Hello and welcome to our latest tutorial with the VFX graph. With our last video giving a short introduction on how to achieve a simple effect, we got a few comments and wishes on what to show next. One of those wishes was to replicate an effect from the game Rocket League, which shows some kind of fancy black hole explosion. You can find a link to the video in the description. Taking a closer look at the effect, we can separate it into four parts. It starts with an explosion of particles that almost immediately slows down and gets sucked towards the center of the effect. The second part is the black hole, which appears in the center. It suddenly grows, stays for a short moment, and then collapses. The third part are the fireworks that start spreading right after the implosion part. The single firework particles leave trails of more particles. And the last part are some sparkles which are generated right after the black hole disappears. This whole graph is a lot more complex than the last tutorial, as you can see here in the VFX editor with the completed effect. Okay, let's take a look at how we can build this effect. The basic setup of a VFX project was already shown in our last video, so we assume that you know how to do that. We will start with a new visual effects graph and simply remove everything that is already in there. Add an event node and give it a name. As you can see, this node has a button to send this event. With this button, we can trigger our effect. We can create a simple particle system to get a template from which we can develop the explosion part. Replace the constant spawn rate in the spawn context with a single burst and set its count to about 800. Now you connect the event to the start input of the spawn context. A press on the send button will now trigger the system. Remove everything from the initialize block and add a position sphere, set lifetime, set velocity, set scale and set size. Also set a capacity to something 2 or 3 times your spawn count. We can leave the settings for the position sphere node on the default values. The lifetime will be set to 0.5. Set the size to 0.5. The scale will be set to 0.1, 0.5, 0.5 to get longer, slimmer particles. For the velocity, we will take the current position, normalize it, and multiply it by a random value between 80 and 120. Next, we can make sure that the quad output is set to blend mode additive and UV mode simple. Set the main texture to the sparkle image. You can find all the images we are using in the archive linked in the description. Remove the set size over life and the orient face camera plane blocks and use an orient along velocity instead. If you trigger the event, now you will barely see any particles. This is because currently they are too fast. We want to achieve the effect of an explosion which is interrupted by a black hole. So in the first moment the particles should expand really fast and then be stopped abruptly. This is done by adding a linear drag node to the update block. Set the coefficient to 20. Upon triggering the event, this looks much better now. But this is only the first part of it. Next, we have to do the implosion. We do this by adding a conform to sphere node. Set the attraction speed to 35, the distance to 0.01 and the force to 0. For the attraction force, we will build a small calculation on the side. Start by creating an age over lifetime node and connect it to a sample curve. Feed this into a multiply and set a parameter b to 500. Connect the output of the multiply to the attraction force of the conform to sphere node. Open the curve of the sample curve node and use the linear preset. Add a key at position 0.6 and set its value to 1. Right-click on it and set both tangents to constant. The last step is to set the first key to 0. This controls the force of the conform to sphere. Change the gradient in the color alpha over lifetime in the output to something like this. This should conclude the first part of our effect, the explosion and implosion combination. Do not forget to name your systems. This one will be called Explosion. So let us continue with the next step, the black hole in the center. For this one, we can again start with the simple particle system. Replace the constant spawn rate with a single burst and set it to count 1. We will talk about the delay later. We can lower the capacity to something small. Remove the set velocity random and the set lifetime random and add a set lifetime. Set the lifetime to 2. The update block can be left empty. Set the texture to the black hole texture we provided in the description. Change the gradient in the color alpha over life to something like this. This will make the ring around the hole glow. Next, adjust the curve in the size over life to something like this, with a fast start, a slow decay in the beginning, and then a faster ending. Now we can connect the event to the black hole graph and test it out. At the moment, both effects start together, but we want the black hole to have a slight delay. We can enter this in the spawn block. Use something small, like 0.3. The fireworks starts with another simple particle system. Like the other parts, we start by changing the spawn to a single burst. Set the count to 30. In the initialized block, set the capacity to 120. Remove the set velocity random and set the set lifetime random to 0.5 and 1. Add a position sphere and set the radius to 0.5. For the velocity, we will use the vector of the current position. Since all positions are on the surface of a sphere, these will point outwards from the center. Add a set velocity. Now we take a getAttributePosition node and feed it to a normalize node. This way we will always start with a vector of length 1 and have a better control over the velocity. Next, we will multiply it by a random number between 30 and 60. Connect this to the set velocity input. Before we try this one out, let us change the main texture to the light dot texture. Switch the blend mode to additive. Connect the event to the spawn block and see how it looks. To give the particles a nicer behavior, add a linear drag to the update and set its coefficient to 5. This will slow them down. Now add a turbulence node with both intensity and drag at 10. This gives the particles a more firework-like look. Remove the set size over lifetime from the quad output and change the gradient of the color alpha over life to something like this. For a better timing of the effect, set the delay in the spawn to 0.5. To make this part even more interesting, we will now add some trails to the particles. For this, we need to enable the experimental operators and blocks from the Preferences Visual Effects menu. This gives us the Trigger Event Always node, which we can add to the update. This will trigger an event in each update cycle. Again, we can use a simple particle system preset to start from. Delete the whole spawn block and create a GPU event context. Now we can connect our trigger to the GPU event and the GPU event to the initialize block. Set the capacity to something high. Remove the set velocity random and add an inherit source position node. Set the lifetime bounds to 0.5 and 0.85. Add a set angle randomize node and set it to the z-axis. Set it to a linear curve from 0 to 1 and then set the last key to 360. A turbulence node in the update adds some variety. Just raise the intensity to 5. Make sure that the blend mode in the quad output is set to additive. As a texture, you can use the splat texture we provided. The size over life can be changed to something like this. Now with the color alpha over life and a gradient like this, the effect looks really nice. For some final sugar coating, we will add a few more particles to enhance the black hole disappearing moment. As before, start with the simple particle system and replace the spawn part with a single burst set to a count of 300. set the delay to 1.4. Set the capacity to 1200. Use the position sphere with a radius of 0.01. Remove the set velocity random. Add a set velocity and reuse the same functionality we used for the fireworks part. Just copy and paste it, but limit the random number range between 1 and 3. Another turbulence node goes into the update with an intensity of 2. Again, the output's blend mode is set to additive. The main texture is again the light dot. We can remove the size over life and change the color alpha gradient to this. Change the orientation to face camera position. The effect is now complete. The only thing to do is to change the render order of the different parts. You can do this in the inspector by dragging the elements to where you need them. For this, we only move the black hole to the bottom so it is rendered above everything else. We really like this effect and hope that you learned something today. Thank you for watching our tutorial. If you like our videos, please subscribe to our channel and give the video a thumbs up. If you have any questions or ideas what we should do next, leave us a comment.